someone had used it for a planter at one point, but you know, everything comes back around and you can use any vase you want in any unique way. But I really love using these rectangular vases because they show off the different curves and angles that you can give varietals in an arrangement. It's not always that like cylinder opening that everything just falls into. So the reason that I chose this is because it's going to work really well with one of our varietals. This one is the Andurian foliage, and I love using this in rectangular vases because it has such a distinct shape and you can use it to create lots of unique texture. The other varietals we have are these beautiful pink snaps. They were actually my favorite flower when I was little, so you can make them top. I also have some aspidistra leaves. We have some cream roses. White Bavaria. And some pink waxflower. So the best thing to do is kind of decide like what you want to be the main focus. And for me, I really want my anthurium leaf and the snapdragons to be the main focus. But in order for me to do that, I have to build a base for it. So you can use all different kinds of things. You could take a piece of twig or something like that and build a support system. But for me, I have all this nice waxflower and I know that it builds a nice lattice. So why wouldn't it? So one thing I like to do is just break these apart a little bit so that I get this nice full texture. Another thing you can do is if you have branches outside, you can just kind of swirl them inside here and it creates that nice structure. I'm not really a fan of using floral tape because it takes away from the movement of the arrangement. I like everything to be a little bit more natural. And the tape, it gets caught, it's hard to clean places afterwards, and who wants that, honestly? So once you've kind of worked through things and I've made this nice loose ball of waxflower, just going to take this and cut these down to the size that I want them to be, which I don't want them to be too tall because they're not supposed to be the statement piece. So I'll take these and I'm just kind of going to line them inside. And this is just the perfect way to build that structure that I want. So next I'm going to take some of my snaps. Anything that goes into that gap that I'd like to cut. just going to add this right along the side as a nice little accent. And then I'll allow some of my stems to kind of fall through the gap. So it has this nice heart-shaped texture. And we'll just let everyone kind of feel like they're spilling out from the leaf. And it's just a really interesting way to do it. So next I'm going to take one of my leaves, these aspidistra leaves, and they're the perfect way to add just like a little bit extra, a little more of that modern structural touch. And I'm just going to release this really in this snap. It's just going to bring everything together a little bit. Then move on to something a little bit smaller. I'll just take some of my roses. There we go. I'll just take off all of those little leaves. And then I like to take off a few of the guard petals. They're there specifically to help your flower get to its destination safely. So now that they're in place, there's no reason not to take them off. And we'll take our Varietals. Mine are all still budded right now, but they'll open up into beautiful, it's more like a square-shaped flower. You'll see it. As they mature, they just pop open like a little diamond that pops. A really unique shape. And then I'm just going to start with a Varietal, since it has this structure to it. And place these. Always going in a cross sample. It's the perfect way to make sure that you have exactly the right shape of an arrangement and to make sure that everything fits in its place. So you see I made a nice triangle with three stems of Varietal. Next I'll take my roses and I want these all to be together in a nice little group. It's a little too tall for me. Almost to the back, because I really do love a Varietal and it needs to be the center of attention every once in a while. The rose can't always take the center stage. There we go. Nice. There we go. And then we have, since I made a little bit of a mess, but we have a nice little small arrangement that you can put your child's room or something like that, or maybe just on your kitchen table. And then a little bit more of a statement. You can just put it right next to your front door so when people walk in, they feel welcome. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll see.